penises in art are bigger or smaller in different periods for symbolic reasons. Breasts also change a lot from one artistic period to the other. They go up, they go down, they go out to the sides, they come into the center of the chest. But for a different reason, breasts in art follow fashion, and specifically, fashion in underclothes. Women in different periods have worn underclothes that have reshaped their bodies to a remarkable degree, hoop skirts, bustles, corsets, and so on. And what's interesting is that artists, or maybe more generally, men's idea of women's naked bodies seems to be heavily influenced by the clothed bodies that they see more often. There are some great examples in the Metropolitan Museum. I'm going to start with a Renaissance painting by Lucas Cranach the Elder of The Choice of Paris, that is, the scene where the Trojan prince Paris chooses which of the three goddesses, Hera, Athena, and Aphrodite, is the most beautiful. In Cranach's painting, the three goddesses all look more or less the same, but their bodies are quite distorted. Their breasts, in particular, are very far apart, almost next to the armpits, with a lot of sternum in between. In addition, all three have the same funny-shaped belly, as if they were just a little pregnant. We can understand why if we look at a painting of a clothed woman from the Renaissance. So let's look at a painting by Filippo Lippi of a courting couple at a window. You immediately see that the woman has a remarkably flat chest, more or less the shape of a man's. Renaissance women wore corsets that flattened the chest by pushing the breasts out to the side, leaving a lot of sternum in between. So that's what men got used to. You also see that she has this funny little pregnant belly, although since she is a young woman being courted, she's presumably a virgin. Like her flattened chest, this belly is made by her underclothes, by a wad of cloth hanging down from her corset, rather like a bustle in the 19th century, but on the front. This is meant, I think, to imply that she's fertile. So what's interesting again is that men who were used to seeing women clothed like this came to imagine their naked bodies as their clothing implied. And so that's what we see in female nudes of the Renaissance.